will learn about literature corner 2 and skills round up 3 and 4. Now, I want you to open your student's book on page 38 and 39. Done? Okay. Now, you will read a story entitled The Railway Children by Edith Nesbit. So, you can listen and read.
Literature Corner 2, page 38, exercise 2. Read and listen. The Railway Children by Edith Nesbit. When the children first went to live at the White House, they talked about Father a lot and were always asking questions about him. But as time passed, their questions seemed to make Mother unhappy, so they stopped asking them. But they never forgot him. Bobby thought about Father often. She knew her mother was unhappy, and she worried a lot about that. And why was Father away for so long? Was there something that Mother wasn't telling them? The answer came on the day she went to the station to fetch the magazines. They were old magazines which people left on trains or in the waiting room. Perks said the children could have them to read, and one day Bobby went to fetch them.
"I'll just put some newspaper round them to keep them together," said Perks. And he took an old newspaper from the heap. The magazines were heavy, and Bobby stopped to rest on the way home. She sat on the grass and dropped them beside her. As she did this, she looked at the newspaper and read some of the words on the page. And it was like a terrible dream. She never remembered how she got home. But she went to her room and locked the door. Then she took the newspaper off the magazines and looked at it again. The words seemed to jump out at her. 5 years in prison for spy. And the name of the spy was the name of her father. Bobby was very quiet at tea time. "Is anything wrong?" Mother asked her. "I'm all right," said Bobby. But after tea, Mother went up to Bobby's room. "What's the matter?" she wanted to know. For an answer, Bobby took the newspaper from under her bed and showed it to her mother. "Oh, Bobby," cried Mother. "You don't believe it, do you? You don't believe Daddy is a spy?"
"No,"
said Bobby. "He's good and honest, and he's done nothing wrong," said Mother. "We have to remember that."
Okay, Michelle, do you like the story? Yes? Good. If you are curious what happened next, you can find out the ebook on the internet and read the rest of the story. Okay, Michelle, now let's look at the exercises in part 1. So in part 1, you have to circle the words in the box which appear in the text. For example, the word waiting room. Do you think the text has the word waiting room? If yes, please circle the word waiting room. And then prison. Do you think the word prison is mentioned in the text? If yes, please circle it. But if not, just let it be like that. Okay, Michelle? Now for part 2, you have to answer the questions based on the story. And for part 3, please answer the questions based on your own idea. Okay, Michelle, that's for page 38. Now let's continue with page 39. In page 39, you will read a text about North Wales. After you finish reading the text, please answer the true or false questions in the first part above the text, okay? Now, after reading, we will listen to an audio program about life in North Wales. So, Michelle, please listen carefully and answer the questions.
Skills Roundup, page 39. Listen. Exercises 1 and 2. Listen to a radio program about life in North Wales. Good morning and welcome to the program Country Eye. This week on the program, we're looking at the beautiful region of North Wales and finding out about what life is like for the people who live there. First of all, we have three young people from North Wales here in the studio. Welcome to the program, Bryn, Gareth and Bethan.
Thanks.
First of all, we are going to hear from Bryn. Bryn, can you tell us a little about your life there?
Yes. Well, I was born on our farm in the village of Dylanog, a little village near Welshpool, and I've lived there all my life. My first language is Welsh. We speak it at home, but I learnt English at school. My dad's a sheep farmer, and I've helped him on the farm for as long as I can remember. I think the Welsh countryside is a wonderful place to grow up. As a kid, me and my brothers had a lot of freedom to run about. Everyone is very friendly, but life is difficult sometimes. There isn't much money in sheep farming, and the winters can be hard.
So do you think you'll stay in North Wales then?
Oh yes. I wouldn't want to live anywhere else. When I finish school, I want to study agriculture at college, but then I'll come back to look after the farm with my dad.
What about you, Gareth? Do you feel the same way?
Actually, no, not at all. I come from the small town of Llangollen. I've lived in Llangollen all my life, and I can't wait to leave. I mean, Llangollen is beautiful. Quite a few tourists come in the summer to go walking in the hills or visit the famous music festival. It is a nice place, and I enjoyed living there when I was younger, but not anymore. Nothing happens, and there's nowhere to go. I want to meet new people and try new things. I'm interested in computers, so I'm planning to go to a university somewhere like London or Cardiff. I want to try city life.
So, Bethan, are you planning to leave the Welsh countryside as well?
Well, no, not really. I live in Caernarfon. It's a small town on the north coast. I've been there all my life, but I don't know if I can stay. You see, there aren't any jobs for people there, especially young people. A lot of young people are moving out of the area because of this. I love where I live. I think it's a beautiful place to live in, but I think that I'll never find a good job there. After I leave university, I'll probably have to live and work somewhere else, and I think that's sad.
I'm sorry to hear that, Bethan. Well, you've heard the views of some young people from the region. What are your views? Call the program now or send us an email and we'll read out your opinions at the end of the show. Meanwhile, listen.
Okay, Michelle, that listening is for doing part 1 and 2. Right, I will remind you that your task for today is page 38, part 1 until 3, and then page 39, the reading and listening part. Okay, Michelle, that's it for today's lesson. See you on the next lesson. Bye-bye.